Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Ekta Saikal Malhotra, founder MQ, along with Ila Dwivedi, co-founder MQ. 365 days back, MQ was initiated. Exactly 1 year today, seven episodes, 22 sessions, 16 distinguished speakers, and many and more appreciating what came straight from the heart. We are happy that we have completed one successful year today on a great day like World Environment Day, where we are trying to create a difference to the environment of our mind, the surroundings around us, and to the mental, physical, emotional well-being of each other. We didn't have a logo until a few days back. A young girl offered us to create a logo for us, which Ila and I found to resonate with our thoughts, and we would like to share that with you. So it is indeed a moment of pride for Ila and me to have been able to go through the ups and downs of MQ for the last 1 year with different kind of conversations, emotions, feelings, having to talk to different kinds of mindsets, different age group, people who we never knew. We got to know them well through this platform, and we owe it all to each one of you who has helped us grow, not only the platform, but ourselves also. So not taking much of your time, I hope you can see. This is what is MQ, money, mentoring, and motivation, which depicts hope, cheerfulness, positivity, a circle of communication amongst all of us. So thank you so much once again on behalf of Ila and myself for being with us for one full year. March and April weren't easy for Ila and myself, but yet we continued our efforts at the background. March, we had our last series, I Chose to Challenge, where Ila was a speaker, but because of her health issues, she couldn't be in the front. April caught me, though we had consciously decided to take a break. We'd invited some articles from all of you. We got some very interesting reads, some thoughts came forward. And when we started to think that when should we come back? So today was the day which was decided. And today, as we celebrate World Environment Day 2021, we have three esteemed speakers with us. Ila, of course, you all know as the co-founder for MQ. Many of you do know that Ila is the founder for My Little Green, who is trying to spread happiness, cheerfulness through those beautiful plants that she creates with proper guidance for care and love to be given to those plants. Not only that, but there is a lot that she does, and I am not going to unveil that because that is going to come straight from her. And for all of you to know, Ila is not doing this as a profession, but it is a passion for her, which she is now living after perhaps looking at the first inning, second inning, this perhaps is the third inning, and a lot more is there up her sleeve. Then we have Sangeeta Venkatesh, who I have reached out to whenever I had struggled with regards to Swachh Bharat Mission, with regards to anything related to the environment or waste management. Leaving genetic engineering and moving into a subject which requires utmost attention by each one of us, Sangeeta has written and authored a book on waste management to let everyone know that how important it is and how it can be done. She also has been constantly writing blogs on this matter and would be talking about a lot of important things with regards to waste management. Now, Ila helps us with plants. And as we all understand, we get our food, the vegetarian food from plants and, you know, all those things, and then gets created waste. which also needs to be managed. Sangeeta is going to help us understand that. Now, you must be wondering, where did the wonder come from? Well, different kinds of wastes are there. What they are, I don't know. I'm also here to learn. But there is a certain amount of waste which translates into wonder. Aur jab wo kachra jiske hum kehte hain wonder mein convert hota hai, to wahan aati hain Shanti Paswan ji, jo ek NGO run karti hain, jo bahut hi sundar sundar cheeze banati hain us waste se, aur kai mahilaon ko involve karti hain, bachcho ko sikhati hain taki wo apni ghar grihasthi ko chala sake, ताकि वो आत्मनिर्भर हो सके. सो शी वर्क्स फॉर हरसेल्फ टुवर्ड स्टैंड अप इंडिया, टुवर्ड आत्मनिर्भर इंडिया एंड मेकिंग वुमेन सस्टेनेबल. नॉट गोइंग एनी फर्दर इनटू एनी ऑफ दीज डिटेल्स, आई एम गोइंग टू इनवाइट इला पचौरी टू टेल अस अबाउट हाउ इम्पॉर्टेंट इट इज फॉर अस टू टेक केयर ऑफ द एनवायरमेंट. हाउ कैन वी डू दैट एंड what is it that we as aam insaan can do sitting at home to make our lives healthy? So over to you, Ila.
Thank you so much, Ekta, and happy first anniversary to us as M Cube. So today we celebrate our first birthday, and what a day to come back after our personal struggles. So thank you all for joining in. And indeed, this is a subject that I have been passionate all through my life. Plants sab log lagate hain apne ghar mein, dekhbhal bhi karte hain. If they die, they replace those plants. No worries, no two second thoughts about that. What worries me till and has been worrying me is the increasing mounds and heaps of waste, jisko hum kachra bolte hain. कचरा मतलब गंदी चीज. उस गंदी चीज को हम एक अच्छी चीज में कैसे बदल सकते हैं? That I have been practicing for the last 4-5 years at an individual level, and I have been persuading my friends, family to make minor changes in their lifestyle so that they can contribute to the environment. Because it's no use blaming the system, blaming the government. बहुत pollution है, बहुत गंदगी है. Who has asked us to get two cars instead of one? If we've got two vehicles, we will go for the third one. Okay? This is how we are creating a menace. सड़कों पे हम गंदगी लेके आ रहे हैं, हवा हम गंदी कर रहे हैं, कचरा हम सड़क पे डाल रहे हैं. कोई गवर्नमेंट वाले लोग आके नहीं डाल रहे हैं. ठीक है, they are trying their best and they could do better. Of course, they can do better. But why can't we as individuals take care of our environment? And as they say, charity begins at home. हमें खुद से शुरुआत करनी होगी. So I start, you know, what disturbed me, Ekta, what disturbed me one day was when I read news in newspaper that cows are dying because they are eating garbage and lots of plastic is getting into their stomach. गाय के पेट से जब postmortem होता था तो 5 kilo plastic निकल रहा है because plastic is the only thing that is never, never going to decompose. It's a growing menace. So at an individual level, on a conscious level, what I started doing was, I started segregating my waste. क्या हो गया? कचरा कैसा होता है? दो तरह का होता है. एक होता है plastic, newspapers, थोड़े odd इधर उधर के papers, थोड़े cardboard boxes या packing cases जो हमारे घर आते हैं, प्लस जितना कचरा हमारे किचन से निकलता है. कोई भी सब्जी के छिलके हो गए, फ्रूट्स के छिलके हो गए, या हम जैसे बोलते हैं कि हमारे घर में पालक की गड्डी खराब हो गई या मेथी खराब हो गई, हमने क्या किया? हमने अनकॉन्शियसली उसको डस्टबिन में डाल दिया. अगर हमारे घर में एक टोमेटो खराब हो गया, एक कीवी खराब हो गया, एप्पल खराब हो गया, पपाया खराब हो गया, हमने सब सड़ी गली चीजों को कचरे में डाल दिया. उस सड़ी गली चीज से आप लोग गोल्ड बना सकते हो. You are getting food from plants, so why not give the same food to your plants? एक cycle बना लेते हैं कि plant से हमको खाना आ रहा है. Non-vegetarians, with due respect to them, non-vegetarians भी जो खा रहे हैं उनमें भी वो लोग जो जिसको वो खा रहे हैं वो लोग भी कहीं जानवर खा वो plants खाकर ही आए हैं. उनका भी vegetarian food भी होता है, उनका एक हिस्सा उनकी diet का. चिकन खाते हैं तो चिकन दाना खाती है और वर्म्स खाती है. सिमिलरली गोट है वो भी पहले चारा खाती है, इट्स अ वेजिटेरियन. सो आई विल नॉट गो इनटू द लेंथ ऑफ दिस डिटेल्स ऑफ दिस, बट हैविंग सेड दैट हम क्या कर सकते हैं, जब हमने कचरा अपने घर में अलग कर लिया है, मेक इट अ प्रैक्टिस नाउ. एंड एज दे से यू मस्ट ऑल हैव रेड, आई गॉट, हम लोग जितने भी लोग यहाँ पे कलेक्ट हुए हैं अभी 17 पार्टिसिपेंट्स इंक्लूडिंग द थ्री ऑफ अस एंड फोर ऑफ अस रादर, थ्री पैनलिस्ट एंड वन एकता आवर होस्टेस. What all we can do on an individual level? जैसे ही आपने अनियंस को छीला उसको पानी के जार में डालिए, जैसे ही बनानास खाए उसको पानी के छिलके को पानी के जार में डाल दीजिए. This is a gold, liquid gold for your plants. Similarly, start making compost. We cannot make excuses. मेरे घर में जगह नहीं है, I have got a small balcony, I have got 3 matkas where I am making compost. You've got old buckets, you've got old matkas, और कोई भी पुराने pots या pans होते हैं जिनके lids होते हैं उसके अंदर आप आराम से compost बना सकते हो. जितना आपका कचरा है उसको इकट्ठा कीजिए, उसके ऊपर soil डालिए. Why not make compost at home? Why add more chemical fertilizers to your plants? So most of you must have seen my plants. I am growing vegetables in my small balcony. And believe me when I say this, that I do not buy organic fertilizers also from the market. I do not buy compost from the market. It's a round the clock process that happens in my kitchen and in my balcony. अगर हम इसकी आदत डाल लेंगे शुरू से, आज से ही अगर हम प्लेज करते हैं, आज 5th जून है, 3 वीक्स के बाद हम दोबारा एक जब एपिसोड के लिए मिलेंगे, तब तक अगर आप लोग सबके सब ये प्रैक्टिस में करोगे कि मुझको दाल चावल का पानी, व्हाट वी डू, वी आर डर्टिंग आवर ड्रेन्स आल्सो. दाल चावल धोया उस पानी को भी आप प्लांट में डाल के आइए. आपने सब्जी धोई है उस पानी को भी आप प्लांट में डाल के आइए. वी कट पोटेटोज एंड वी वॉश देम बिफोर मेकिंग अ वेजिटेबल आउट ऑफ इट. Then those cut potatoes soaked in water, that water is so mineral rich, it is so nutrient rich, it is so important that it should ideally go to the plants. However busy I am, maybe I get up at 5:30, I'm in the kitchen at 6 o'clock. Believe me, when I go to the kitchen, dal dhoi, main pani dalne paudhon mein aati hu. Maine chawal dhoya, main pani dalne wapas balcony mein aati hu. मैंने सब्जी धोई है, जो भी कुछ मैं वॉशिंग कर रही हूँ, जो भी कुछ कर रही हूँ उसको मैं फटाफट में आती हूँ. आई कम एंड इतना सा पानी होता है ना, किसी भी एक पॉट में डाल दीजिए. ये हमें छोटे छोटे चेंजेस अपने अंदर आने पड़ेंगे, लाने पड़ेंगे. और आई एम स्टिल लर्निंग, दिस इज अ ह्यूज 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 एरिया वेयर आई ऑल्सो हैव लॉट्स ऑफ लर्निंग टू डू. एंड आई थैंक संगीता फॉर दैट, बिकॉज शी टॉट मी हाउ टू मेक बायो फर्टिलाइजर्स एट होम लास्ट ईयर. एंड bio fertilizers, bio enzymes, since the last 8 months, ever since I learnt them from Sangeeta, that process also is being continued in my place. Chahe wo nimbu ke chhilke hote hain, oranges ke peels hote hain, aajkal mango peels ho gaye, kisi ka bhi chhilka hota hai, it goes with good and water and I make lovely bio fertilizers out of those peels.
So Ela, yes, you know, what you just shared with us is a very simple thing to do, right?
Yeah, of
and,
course.
And gone are those days, you know, where we lived in very palatial house. Perhaps our plants would not be maybe 20 steps away from where our kitchen would be, or maybe 30 steps, right? But yet, there are so many of us who don't do this. What are the excuses that typically one would give that they don't want to do as simple and as basic as this? And as Ela has Sangeeta to thank, I have Sangeeta as well as Ela to thank, because that's exactly what I do. I've kept a bucket right next to my kitchen dustbin and all my wet waste goes there. And then my daughter, now even my daughter who's just 4.5 knows that no peel or anything has to be thrown in the dustbin, but she will still reconfirm that, Mama, should I put it in this basket or somewhere else?
Exactly.
So what are our excuses? Why are we not doing it? And before you answer this, the theme for 2021 is, you know, the restoration of the ecosystem. Those are very big words. We're talking about restoring so many resources and everything. But, well, the environmentalists are working towards it. but what are we really contributing towards it? Because those small, small initiatives that we take at our home will actually make a difference. So Ila, what are our excuses?
First excuse, time nahi hai. Pehla excuse yehi hota hai, we don't have the time, we are busy, very busy. Either like moms are busy with their kids or working women, they say that I have got office. I have to cook, then I have to rush to the office. But as Ekta said, if you keep a separate bucket with a lid in the corner next to your sink, automatically your hands will start reaching out to that sink to put your like kitchen waste. Just thoda thoda. And one more thing that I would like to mention here is when we are using ROs at home, jab hum RO use karte hain water purifying ke liye, we are using this much of water and wasting this much. So I have extended that RO pipe, that outlet pipe, and I have kept it into that bucket only. So whatever water I filter, the waste water goes into that bucket. So I also keep a separate bucket to save that water because I use it for my daily pocha jhadu. आरओ के पानी से आप पोछा लगा सकते हो क्योंकि वो गंदा नहीं होता है. आरओ के पानी से आप पौधों में डाल सकते हैं क्योंकि उसमें मिनरल्स होते हैं, न्यूट्रिएंट्स होते हैं. सो व्हाइल वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट या रिस्टोरेशन की जब हम बात करते हैं, वाटर अगेन इज गोइंग टू क्रिएट अ वेरी वेरी बिग सिचुएशन लाइक इन ईयर्स टू कम. सो इट्स हाई टाइम दैट इंस्टेड ऑफ वेस्टिंग टू बकेट्स ऑफ वाटर फॉर योर डेली पोछा, यूज दैट आरओ वाटर. एंड एक्सक्यूजेस की बात करते हो तो याद ही नहीं रहता, क्या फायदा है, जिसको करना है वो कर ले, हमें क्या पड़ी है, अपना घर साफ कर लिया, बाहर कचरा डाल दिया, सरकार करेगी. नो केजरीवाल, नो मोदी इज गोइंग टू कम एंड लिफ्ट दैट बकेट ऑफ और दैट बिन फॉर यू.
एब्सोल्युटली.
देन यू कंप्लेन, आज कचरे की स्मेल आ रही है, आज शाफ्ट क्लीन नहीं हुआ सोसाइटी का, आज बहुत कचरे की स्मेल आ रही है, आज ना हवा इधर से चल रही है तो कचरे का जो यू नो अभी हैव अ लैंडफिल जस्ट 2 kilometers अहेड ऑफ अस गाजीपुर. हूएवर स्टेज इन दिल्ली एनसीआर इज वेल अवेयर ऑफ गाजीपुर लैंडफिल. एक बहुत बड़ा पहाड़ है जो बड़ा होता जा रहा है, होता जा रहा है, होता जा रहा है. एंड उस पहाड़ के लिए सबको चिंता होती है, बदबू आ रही है, बदबू आ रही है, या एक दिन उसमें कुछ केमिकल रिएक्शन हो गए थे एंड अ चंक ऑफ दैट माउंटेन, garbage mountain came crashing and it took away passers by in its stride. Nale mein log gir gaye the, car chali gayi thi nale mein, and there was a loss of I think 3 to 5 lives. So this is a menace. Hum shikayat hi karte hain. Agar aaj hum hamare ghar mein average household mein I think 1 kilo se 1.5 kilo kitchen waste nikalta hai. If they are pure vegetarians, because salad ho gaya, vegetables ho gaya, aloo, pyaaz, this and that, whatever you are cooking, ghee ho gaya. Ideally, 1 kg waste, if you start reusing it as compost or liquid fertilizer, 1 kilo waste into 30 days, into 365 days. ऐसे करो, तो आप सोचो आपने कितना किलो कचरा का contribution कम कर दिया environment में.
Very true.
Isn't it interesting? And the onus is totally upon us.
And that's exactly my question to all the audience who are there with us on Zoom as well as on Facebook. Is it really difficult to do this? You know, we all like to look for very, very complicated solutions. But does the answer always lie in a complicated solution? We had Earth Day a few days back. And I wanted to explain to my 4.5-year-old that bitter, don't waste water, because at the rate that the water gets wasted with all those luxury bathtubs and so on and so forth, perhaps by the time children of my daughter's age grow up, there might be scarcity, and there already is scarcity.
Yes.
You know, there was this series on Netflix that I had seen where there were fights because of water and whatnot. All I did was made her draw the earth, color it around, and explain her in a very joyful manner that, you know, I partially colored the earth blue and partially black. And that made her ask me that why is that black and why is the other part green. So I told her because the earth is crying.
Yeah.
Now every time she puts the water on for a very long time, she'll immediately say, oh, mama, earth is crying. So she'll switch it off. If a small child of 4.5 year old can understand this, can get into that practice of throwing that waste into a bucket designated for that. And let me tell you, perhaps it would be more relevant when Shanti ji comes in, but that 4.5 year old child today does not want to throw anything in the dustbin. Because she will come and say, hum iska kuch craft work kar lete hain. And let's convert it. So every tissue paper roll in my house is converted into a pen stand like this.
Beautiful.
And with this, I achieve multifold objectives. She's tutored, she's mentored. Our waste is, converted into something beautiful. And we are trying to protect the environment. Thank you so much, Ila, for sharing that very, very simple and easy to understand. And I'm sure many of you would want to really implement this. Ila spoke about, that Ghazipur waste dump yard falling. There is a city in our very own country which has managed waste beautifully. And this is not something that I have read. I have firsthand experienced on my visit to that city. The city where Sangeeta partially represents that city, which is Bangalore. Waste segregation, managing it is ingrained in their system. So much so that that week that we stayed there with my in-laws, we got into the habit of, kind of segregating the waste and putting it in the right bin in the right manner. Because we knew if we didn't do it, we would be corrected that, okay, you have to do it like that. If one city can do it so beautifully, what stops us? Let us understand all about waste management from Sangeeta.
So, good evening, everybody. It's a pleasure being here and happy congratulations on the first anniversary, Ekta and Ila of MCube. It's nice to share this day with you all. And so what I will do is perhaps share a PowerPoint to really explain what I want to say. You said some very nice things about Bangalore and my heart is bursting, but I do feel sometimes even we can go a long way, but yes, we have come a long way, but yet a long way to go. So that is what I will talk to you. So is everybody able to see this? Yeah. So waste to wonder, and thank you, MCube, for having me here. So happy Environment Day to everybody on Zoom as well as on the Facebook page. Now, what you see is this little fella, his name is Wrigley. Okay, he is a mascot of my book, The Waste Issue, which you can see the cover here. So in the book, Wrigley takes you through all the tips about waste management. Now, why is Wrigley the mascot? Because he's an earthworm and he does such wonderful things that human beings can understand, get to learn a lot from him. For instance, you have seen, jab bhi barish hoti hai, these earthworms go in, they burrow inside the soil and they mix up the soil and the leaf litter gets all mixed, they degrade it. And what they are doing is actually rejuvenating the soil by breaking down the organic matter to simple nitrogenous compounds, hydrocarbons and, stuff like that. So therefore, we chose an earthworm as our mascot. So before I go ahead, I really want to ask all of you, what's your dream city like? think about it, you can just put it in the chat box. We can discuss about it later. You can just give your comments in the Facebook page. So what is your dream city like? You know, what are your aspirations? What do you want for your city? So keep that thought throughout this presentation. What do you want it to be like? So now, as human beings, we get up in the morning, we have a lot of activities, right? We wake up, brush our teeth, have a shower, and dress up and go for breakfast and all that. And till the end of the day, till you go to bed, there are so many activities. Okay, so what happens? Now, once you've brushed your teeth, okay, one fine day, your brush, is ready to be disposed, or your toothpaste has gotten over and you want to throw it in the dustbin, okay? Your bread, it is packed in some plastic. So you need to throw that in the dustbin, and so on and so forth. Your phone kharab ho jati hai, then you want to waste, throw that also. So what are you doing? You're basically creating waste. So anything which has no use is, in our terms, as waste, right? So what happens when you put it in the dustbin? Have you ever thought, dustbin mein dalne ke baad ab kya kahan jata hai wo? Do you ever think about where it is going? As long as it is out of my sight, it is not my business. Is what is our attitude all the while? So this is known as the NIMBY syndrome. As long as it's not in my backyard, anything, anywhere it goes, it's not my business. So this is a very dangerous syndrome to have and thought to have. Because once something comes on the earth, there is no going away. It is always there. Somewhere on the earth, it will be there. The first plastic that was made in the 60s or, 50s, it's still somewhere around. It has not gone anywhere. So therefore, there is no such thing as away. When we throw anything, it must go somewhere. So where does it go is the question. And this is what happens. This is such a familiar sight in all our cities, right? Yeah, because they are, all mixed waste is there, kachra is there, the cows are eating. It's a holy mess, right? So this is the dirty picture, not Vidya Balan's, but our own mess in the city. So Ila just talked about Mount Ghazipur. So I call it the Mount Ghazipur because there was an audience, a large audience, which is really in the NCR region. I said, I must bring this, I have gone there personally. And, the mountain, I think that is all garbage, which is being piled up and up and up and up. And what is happening there? Actually, I had to go there on World Toilet Day the year 2016 with a delegation, with an Egyptian delegation. And here we were, sightseeing. It was a matter of shame, really. Of course, our country is not the only one which has a landfill, but, there are other landfills which are sanitary landfills. That means there is a casing which is done. So there, even if something is put, it doesn't leach out and all that. So this is a terrible thing to have in the capital of the country. And this gentleman with the beard, if you can see, he is the head of the this Waste Pickers Association. He was the one, and he does a lot of work for the welfare of the waste pickers. Now that is what I'm coming to, because we are it is not just an ecological issue. It is also a social issue that we need to talk about. Waste, the ramifications are quite a bit, not just ecological. So you can see, if you can see that pani which is coming out, that leach it, that is all coming from the Ghazipur landfill. And from a distance, you could see waste pickers and all that holy mess trying to eke out a living. They are disregarding their health. It's such a health hazard. Yet, because they have such a good knowledge about recycling, so they know exactly from all that waste, they will pick out things store it and go and sell it to a recycler. So our kachada that is going there is actually a bread and butter for somebody else. So imagine if we had actually just separated it and give it to them, and how, you know, if they had worn gloves or thing, look at the conditions they are working in. It is a very sad thing. Okay, so in fact, this is the thing. 50 years back, the largest man-made structure on planet Earth was a wall of China. But today, it is a New York waste dump. So even the most advanced countries are creating a lot of waste. Our India's is creating a lot, but the per capita waste is thoda kam, but it is still one. We are one of the largest waste producers. So what is bad waste management? When you dump your waste, now when you burn your waste, and of course landfill. Now every nook and corner I have seen, because I have activist friends in Delhi who really are being behind this waste burning. Now, when we are all during COVID times, we are looking for oxygen. Here, you know, what oxygen God has given us, we are burning our waste and removing the oxygen from the air, right? So that's another very sad situation. So that's another reason why we really need to be very scientific in our waste management. And it's so simple, really. So I always say that, how developed is a nation? A developed nation is as good as its public spaces. Okay? So when you go abroad in Europe, oh, it's so beautiful. Look at the parks and all that. And therefore, we call it a developed city, isn't that? Why? Because there is an aesthetic, there is cleanliness, and much of our culture, cultural ethos of a city is shaped by our public space. You know, can we send our children out to play? Is there a place like that? Or are we scared of the traffic? Are we scared of the waste being dumped? You know, are we scared about their health? So all that goes into shaping a city. So now, after Ghazipur, this is another thing. Like I told you about the waste workers. Close to Ghazipur is this basti called Simapuri Colony. Okay, and see, this is how they live. So imagine if we had segregated well and all that and given them a good living condition. You know, they also can do something for the society and also earn their own money, you know, holding their head high, right? Because they have a fantastic knowledge. In all that, in that mess, when I went, there was a shadi happening. Then this kid, who's a, you know, look at her age. She should be playing in a playground. Her playground was this dump yard. These guys are all waste pickers who separate and all that. Because of the sheer, you know, the condition they live in, you know, many of them take drugs just to forget or to get desensitized so that they can put up with all that trash which is around. So therefore, I very strongly feel about why we should segregate and why these people should have a decent life. We owe it to them. So here you can see plastics. There are nearly about 50 kinds of different plastics which will go to a recycler. And that is, you know, you and me, we will sit, for us it will be just plastic. But they know the second level, third level, fourth level of the thing. So why I'm telling you all this is just to tell you why we should be segregating, so that you get to know the science behind it as well as social aspect. So bad waste management, what happens? You get visual pollution, you get pests, you get, obviously you get diseases, then soil gets polluted. And of course, eventually from the leachate, it goes into the groundwater comes to your taps and even we fall. So it's a vicious cycle. So forget, if we were to get this, you know, like the COVID data, which comes every day, that so many active cases, so many died, so many recovered, I'm telling you, they should do for diarrhea also. Then we will really know what conditions we live in. Because nearly, like I said, 1 in 5 children, you know, they are dying every day. You know, every day. That is the statistics in rural areas as well as urban areas. So where are we going wrong? So that is why we need to keep the waste issue in the focus. So here is where I want to bring you to a concept called as a open loop and a closed loop. Okay, so closed loop matlab kya? You know, when we were kids, there is a place called Malleshwaram in Bangalore, and my grandmother would live in a very palatial kind of a bungalow. At that time, Bangalore had lovely bungalows with lot of yard, and she had a cow, 3-4 cows in the backyard, jackfruit and banana, mango trees and all that. So I would go there for my holidays. It was really blissful. So what is this? So you have this banana tree. You can see that from there you pluck a banana. You eat the banana and you have the peel. So what do you do to the peel? We would give it to the cow along with the rest of the fodder. So then the cow poops and you get the cow dung. That cow dung was either used as fuel by my grandmother, she would put on the wall, or, you know, make gobar and feed it back. So this is not something very exclusive. These things were happening all over India. And this was what we called a closed loop or a circular economy, you know, if you want to use jargon. So this is cradle to cradle is the what is it is called. Instead, abhi kya ho raha hai? We eat the banana, we are putting in the dustbin. Uske saath, there is plastic, there is paper, there is everything. Very few places segregation is happening. I'm very thankful my city is doing it. And where we lived, even before the BBMP, that is the civic administration, which mandated it, we were started doing it in 2002 itself. So, you know, even before it was a law. So what happens is, neither can you recycle the dry waste, nor can you do the wet waste. So what happens? Mount Ghazipur happens. Can you see that? So that is the case. So that is very important. That is why we need to separate the waste. Also, for each item that we use in a day, think about it. It's so easy to do shopping now. Amazon, go click of a button, card, credit card, and you're done. But think about it. How long, whatever I have bought, how long will it stay on this earth? Right? So you can see from the chart, you can see styrofoam. I mean, you can have generations until probably some kind of pralay happens, you know. Till then, styrofoam will be there. Plastic will be there for 1 million years. Sanitary waste, your diapers that you're using, if you have not disposed it properly, it will be there for 500 to 600 years. Sanitary napkins will be around for 500 to 600 years. So tin cans, 50 to 100 years. So therefore, I'm really keen to see how Shantiji will tell us how to, you know, upcycle all this. But imagine even a thing like banana peel takes 3 to 4 weeks. So what can we do? Each one has to jumpstart a process. So why segregation? Segregation is so. So now I've shown you these dustbins. Okay, green. You can use any color dustbin, but here, you know, I always represent green for the organic waste, blue for dry waste, red for sanitary waste, yellow for e-waste or anything else, okay? And also you have so much of debris from construction and all that. So the thing is, we keep on adding to our waste generation. So I want to give you some examples how it can be done in real life, you know. So no more gyan now. How can you do? So I needed to first give you the science behind it, why you must do it, the ecological and the social part of it. Now let us sit back and see, okay, I'm going to do something about it. So this is case study one, which is a gated community, and that's where I live in. And I moved in here after we built the house in 2002. So one day I was taking a walk and I saw a truck being taken, truckload of waste. And I said, where is this going? So I asked our maintenance office and they said it's going to Hoskote. I think there is a you know, and then I discovered there is a landfill again, Mandur. Okay, and there people are living. It used to be a orchard, you know, and there because of the landfill, the whole soil and the groundwater got polluted and toxic, and all those orchards just disappeared. So I thought it was really unfair, and so, but we were very lucky that we have a very a nice set of like-minded people, and there was a committee formed, you know, and then I researched and got an NGO called the Waste Wise Trust, which is run by an Ashoka fellow, Mr. Anselm Rosario, and we campaigned. So what I'm saying is this is how it can be done. It is not saying, okay, one fine day you put a notice saying, Abhi, you do all this. It will not work that way. You will need to do a campaign. You know, so we did for nearly about 610 families. And then we have to say, okay, first, you know, keep your wet waste, dry waste, biomedical waste and all that, you know, separation. And then, you know, right now it is so fine-tuned that even our expired medicine, our e-waste is also collected separately for disposal. So that is the stage where we have come, because we started early 2002. And it's not impossible. Everybody can do it. We just need to have the will. So I'm just giving you the thing, organic, if you can just see that I've already explained that earlier. Now case, so these were independent houses which I was talking about. Now going to apartment complexes, what can you do? Apartments, sometimes they say that, okay, we don't have enough place and all that, but you can do your bit. For instance, right across the where I live, you know, the road is an apartment where they have put in, these are leaf composters. So they're just putting leaf on leaf, and that just gets, you know, by itself will get some, you know, compacted and gets composted. It is so easy. What is a big rocket science in that? Everybody can do it. And your leaves are a great source of nutrient for the soil. And then they have this drum, you know, which is available with so many vendors. That is where, so they have bought a whole lot of them where they're putting their organic waste like that. And they're putting whatever your starters for composting and all that. And then they shut it, and this is what, and then they rotate it every day and they keep filling it. And then the end of it, they're getting this beautiful gold for the soil. And this is what is so, even apartments can do it. So it's just that you need to do some amount of research. You talk with your apartment people. Let's do it. It's so easy. Let us not contribute more waste to landfills. That is the attitude you have to have. So suppose you're not either in an apartment nor in a gated community. What can you do? There are so many choices. You have this Kamba, and you know, this is a friend of mine. I've taken her permission to use it, this picture. So like, you know, she's been using this, though she's in my own community. There are a lot of people who are doing their own composting. So this is how composting happens. So I don't want to go into the details of the science about it, that you can find out. This is from my book, actually. Basically, you know, the microorganisms act on it and give you manure and, you know, and set out, give out carbon dioxide, heat and water. So the appropriate method of composting can be chosen, and you can choose it. This is again all our waste that was going to WasteWise back in 2002. And with all this compost, they were actually growing so many plants in that area. Okay, so what have we done by composting? We have closed the loop again. Again, cradle to cradle, like I told you. So remember, folks, composting is recycling. Now, so out of so many, you know, we've in the so-called fast life, as we call it, you know, we want everything instantaneously. So, and also the market has provided it. So you remember, this is how we shopped, right? In these, we used to go to a Kirana shop and, you know, we open lentils and rice and all that. Now everything is packaged and we have disposable, you know, cutlery and all that. So many tins, layers, things. So at the end of it, just check your dustbins. How much of dry waste do you have every day? Okay. And this plastic pollution is really killing us. And especially the 20 micron ones, which are banned now, but still it makes its way, you know, somehow into the shops and all that, because that cannot be recycled. And it is so light, it will fly somewhere, it will land up somewhere in your sewers, it will, you know, and one rain, your cities are flooding, and then it finally goes into the oceans. And, you know, by that small mistake you have done, you're killing all the marine animals. So they're choking, actually. So when, in fact, you must have heard of the Versova Beach cleanup, you know, the lawyer, Afroz. After they did the cleaning up, can you imagine the Olive Ridley's turtles came back? So this is, for all your praise for Bangalore Ekdal, this is actually on Commercial Street, which I took a picture. So this has also happened. So we are also getting, not perfect, we have still a long way to go. And exactly what, like Ila said, you know, these ruminants, you do the post-mortem, you will get tons of plastic from their stomach. So this is how we do it. Okay, you have these bag, a trolley, we have kept these, you know, these buckets, and they goes house to house, and they collect your dry waste, and it goes to a recycler like this. And see, this is how they separate it again, even your tissue paper, how it is separated, and it goes for recycling. So there is so much of potential in recycling. So don't undermine your activity of segregation. It is the most important thing you can ever do in your life, because 75% of municipal solid waste, whatever is coming out from your house, is known as municipal solid waste. Everything can be recycled. Okay, so here is another list. I won't go through it. Okay, so basically zero waste is a concept. We can never be zero waste, but zero waste is recycling less. Because I would say recycling should be the last thing you need to do. First thing is refuse what you don't need. Reduce what you need. Okay? So I'm asking you to become a quasi-monks, but you have to take it in the right spirit. Reuse what you have. Okay? Only if you can't do everything else, send it for recycling. So keep thinking, okay, I have this pen in my hand. What will happen to it? I'm sitting on this chair. What will happen to it? So this is the inverted pyramid. Landfill should be the last place it should go. Okay. So this is what. So what else can you do? Carry your own bags. Carry your own bottle. I mean, I have taken my own bottle even in aircrafts. Okay, after my security check, I have my empty bottle. I go to the, where the water is collection. I fill it up. Rags instead of paper towels. I mean, paper towels is, I think, such a wasteful, the ultimate in wasteful living. Handkerchiefs instead of tissues. Refuse plastic straws. You just cannot be recycled. You can think of using bamboo toothbrushes, bamboo earbuds. Buy it in bulk. Now, you can actually, even Delhi has a lot of, such a nice drawing. Okay. These people who give if you take your own boxes, they give you your lentils and dal and rice and all that in that. So you can buy it in bulk and store it in your containers. Now, if you can see this picture, you can even this shiny plastics that you use for gift wrapping, it can never be recycled. It will certain to go to a landfill. Use newspapers, do a nice drawing on it. And see, this is how I actually carry a glass and a spoon in a bag, and that goes into my purse. So I never have to use a plastic. And it's more hygienic, right? And those are some upcycling examples I've shown you. That's a CD with a diya, and some painting has been done by some kids, okay? This is what you can do. But if you really want to go back again to see how you can do it in your communities, it's all about, one is government level policies, then your own participation. Okay, so if in your community you have a passionate core team which has the knowledge, you know, then you start a dialogue with each other, create an awareness, then you build an, you know, relations with each other. You know, this is how, you know, step by step, and do it in a very amicable way so that there is no ladai chagda. Because many a good project gets derailed because of that. And then training of housekeeping staff, if you're in an apartment, then there will be a lot of mistakes which will happen. So don't get discouraged. You know, they say 90 days to a habit. It is with waste management. And there are vendors who will actually help you. I'm not sure if Nupur Tandon has joined the Zoom call. I had sent her an invite. She is the owner of Pro Waste Concepts. She has, absolutely overturned green campuses into green campuses by training housekeeping. After she does it, she leaves it. It's a self-sustaining model. So there are vendors who will help you. So it's not as if you have to do the whole thing. So, and you don't have to feel intimidated. So I am a proponent of a decentralized mode. Decentralized means one civic administration. What is it in Delhi? I'm not too sure. Here, for Bombay, it is BMC. Here it is BBMP in Bangalore. We don't have to depend on one body. You know, there has to be some smaller bodies where, you know, they collect your waste and they treat it in a, for instance, if I'm in Whitefield only, it gets sorted out. That means you don't have to take transportation and, you know, large infrastructure for processing facilities or landfills and all that. So the company I work for is Eco Paradigm in Bangalore. We have also created a cloud, app kind of a thing, where on a truck, if that thing is placed, it is in real time, you know how much your waste is, you know, whether wet waste kitna hai, dry waste kitna hai, and it has a GPS tracking. So we know if somebody has skipped a house or somewhere somebody has given mixed waste and all that. So there are a lot of innovations that is happening, correct? Okay. And we just need to tap into all that. So then after that, actually, with all the data also can be studied by the experts, okay, monitoring the waste composition. So it's a very wonderful science to say. So, okay, now this COVID is a temporary thing, I hope, and I'm sure we will go back to celebrating. And the shadis and all that, we all love to celebrate. Now, next time you want to have a party or a marriage, think about how you want to celebrate, you know, use, exactly. I mean, you know, I'm sorry. You have to use flowers for decorations instead of those buntings. And, you know, you can use reusable steel glass. There are common pools, you know, cutleries, they hire it, you know, even if you don't have it at home. Think a little out of the box and do all this, you know, and you don't need mineral water. Mineral water, you really don't know. I'm telling you, it may not be as safe as it sounds. You know, just fill it up from your house, you know, in these large, how we used to go for picnics in our childhood, right? Taking these, what was that called? Flasks or whatever. Huh? Yeah, and even your decorations that can be reused. You know, birthday parties, which are return gifts, can be eco-friendly. You know, avoid plastic. Give something meaningful, which is of use, and things like that. So the impact can be so much with just these small things, okay? And this is what we had done in our locality. We used to give a kind, we had a competition. So we can, you know, many cities can do that also. You know, if one star for each thing, if you segregate waste, one star. If you compost it, second, and so on and so forth. You know, and so there was a big program and, you know, things like that. So what I'm trying to say is finally, we have to get rid of the linear economy and move towards the circular economy. And with that, I want to say, celebrate the earth. This is another book that I have written. It's a story from the Srimad Bhagavatam. And that's what we need to do. We have to celebrate the earth, and only then we can celebrate life. and we leave a nice, healthy planet so that our children, our grandchildren, think about them, that's it, and teach them, and then I think that's the only duty that we have on this planet, in my opinion. And so with that, I will stop the share. I hope it wasn't too long, and I hope you didn't get bored. but this is really of something I'm very passionate about, so I get carried away. I just hope you enjoyed it. And anytime you want any doubts to be cleared, please do reach out to me. Thanks, Ekta, Hila.
Pleasure, Sangeeta. Thank you. That was indeed, I think, a very important aspect that you brought out as to how do we really work towards it. You know, like I had asked Ila that what are the excuses? And of course, I think the excuses are pretty much the same when it comes to segregating our waste. Time nahi hai, kaun karega? You know, the garbage collector will do it, the conventional school of thought. But come to think of it, actually the conventional school of thought was where you actually segregated the waste. Like, you know, Ila said in the beginning, or even Sangeeta showed, that all the, you know, the vegetable waste, the peels and everything was kept aside for the, you know, those pet animals that we kept at our home, be it a cow, buffalo, or a goat, right? So when all of that was done, then what stopped us? Well, of course, yes, we have so much to do. And, you know, we have so much little time. But come to think of it, the future depends on this.
It actually doesn't take time, in my opinion. Actually, all you need is 3 buckets, for heaven's sakes. Yes. And you just need to, the number of steps you take to one bucket, the number of steps you take is going to be the same, you know. And it's like I said, do it 90 days to have it. It'll be done. And then you'll notice, you know. And like I said, we have gone to another level now. Even our disposed expired medicines, we are keeping it separately. It's not going to waste.
Exactly. So I think the pandemic has taught us how to dispose of our masks and so on and so forth. But my question to all of you here is that all that Sangeeta spoke about, right, which she was saying that, you know, she's giving us gyan. I just have one simple question to ask. Most of us here have traveled abroad at least once in our lifetime till now, right? When we go there, when we throw a can, we look at the bin which has the marking that throw the can here, or the food waste. Even a child will look there, because everyone out there knows that you shall be penalized. You will pay up a fine if you do that. Are we waiting for that situation to arise even in our own country, when we want to copy the Western world to the T for anything and everything? Why are we not looking at such good practices? They are looking at the cultural benefits that our country offers, the value system that our country offers, and so much and more, right? Why is it that we cannot learn from them? And as Sangeeta said, Ila said, that just a few extra steps physically, but a lot to change here. A lot to change for ourselves, for our environment, for the people around us. In fact, I'm not too sure if Sangeeta would remember this instance, but we had a neighbor who would throw garbage from their second floor into my house.
Correct. I do remember.
And that's when
also remember this.
That Swachh Bharat Mission conversation had come into play. Yes. And but you know what really happened good by her throwing that garbage was that the papaya seeds went into a kind of a small planter that we had, and it grew. And I think a few months down the line, dengue had, you know, hit Delhi very badly. So a lot of passerby would pluck those leaves and take. So that was blessing in disguise. But as she said, what goes out of my house, I am not bothered about. But my house should be clean. How many of us actually pay attention towards the surroundings that we live in? This is where our children will grow. If environment is, you know, that Hindi mein bolte hai ki dharti hamari mata hai, gaay hamari mata hai, and so on and so forth. Aur unhi ko hi hum itna gand feed kar rahe hain. we really need to ponder over. And I don't want to make it a very, like a blame game. All of us including in this.
Eta, we should stop sloganeering.
Yes.
And do it. That's it.
Exactly. We should just do it. And how many of you will be doing it is a question. You know, with 18, 20 of us here and a couple of them on Facebook. So even 35 of us are hearing this. I'm saying even leaving Ila, Sangeeta and Shanti, if even one, two of us really makes that change, you know, we will do a lot. Now, Sangeeta spoke about the waste management. Dry waste, wet waste. And उन्होंने कुछ ऐसी चीजें भी दिखाई जो recycle कर सकते हैं. Recycling से बहुत कुछ बन सकता है जिससे आपका घर बहुत सुंदर बन सकता है. एंड इस चीज की जो अहमियत है आप तभी समझोगे जब आप खुद उस चीज को करोगे. जब एक पुरानी बॉटल को आप रोप लगा के, रस्सी होती है हमारी, उसको डेकोरेट करके अपने ड्राइंग रूम में रखेंगे और कोई उसकी तारीफ करेगा तो आपको लगेगा कि हाँ आपने कुछ अच्छा किया है. एक टूटे हुए ग्लास को अगर आप पेंट कर दोगे या जो टैटर्ड कपड़े होते हैं, फटे पुराने कपड़े होते हैं, अगर उसमें से सुंदर सुंदर क्लिप्स बन जाएं आपके बच्चे के लिए, न्यूज़पेपर से पेपर बैग्स बन जाएं, न्यूज़पेपर से ऐसा सुंदर पेन बन जाए, तो आपको उसको फेंकने का बिल्कुल भी मन नहीं करेगा क्योंकि आप ही की चीज आप ही के पास रहेगी. जो आपने उस पर स्पेंड किया है उसकी वैल्यू शायद अनगिनत हो जाएगी. पर वो कैसे वो चीजें बनती हैं, क्यों उस चीज के ऊपर शांति जी काम कर रही हैं, कैसे उनको इस चीज का आइडिया आया, क्या उनका मोटिव है, कैसे वो सब महिलाओं को ट्रेन करती हैं, हम शांति जी से सुनेंगे. तो बहुत बहुत स्वागत है आपका शांति जी.
थैंक यू सो मच एकता जी, इला जी एंड संगीता जी, और हैप्पी बर्थडे एमक्यू. थैंक यू सो मच. मैं रिसाइकल, ये अपसाइकल का काम करती हूँ. जो वेस्ट क्लॉथ होता है और जो वेस्ट न्यूज़पेपर होता है उसके ऊपर काम करती हूँ. और सबसे पहले मैंने न्यूज़पेपर के ऊपर काम स्टार्ट किया. हमने छोटे छोटे लिफाफे बनाए और उसको हम बेकरी वाले के पास सेल आउट किया. तो धीरे धीरे उसमें एक बहुत बड़ा ऑर्डर आया और इस तरह से हम लोग आगे बढ़ते रहे. एक करके, दो करके, तीन करके लेडीज को जोड़ा. मैं स्कूल्स में टीचर्स और इनको एनजीओस में ट्रेनिंग देने लगी. तो ट्रेनिंग देने लगी तो मैं पेपर से ही पहले करती थी, पेन बनाना, कैरी बैग बनाना, बुक मार्क बनाना. फिर धीरे धीरे आइडिया आया कि हम क्यों ना क्लॉथ पे भी करें, क्योंकि बहुत सारा क्लॉथ हमारे घरों में दिवाली में बहुत निकलता है, बहुत लोग डोनेट करते हैं और हम वो कलेक्ट करने लगे. यहाँ तक कि हम बुटीक में भी जाकर हम कलेक्ट करने लगे, जैसे छोटे छोटे कट पीस होते हैं ना वो, क्योंकि वो नया नया कपड़ा मिल जाता था हमें. और एक आइडिया आया कि ये जो अपसाइकिल है उसको हम करेंगे, क्योंकि उसमें मेरे पास उतना पैसा नहीं था, कभी पैसा था 1,33,000 रुपए. तो मैंने उसी से काम शुरू किया. तो उसमें मैंने 10 लेडीज को जोड़ा, धीरे धीरे करके 30 लेडीज हो गई. और फिर हम लोगों ने खूब अच्छे से काम किया और हम उससे ज्वेलरी बनाने लगे कपड़े से, और बुक मार्क बनाने लगे के कपड़े, पेन से, कागज से, और बैग, और जो कट पीस होते हैं उसको जोड़ जोड़ कर इतने सुंदर सुंदर हमने बैग बनाए और हेयर एसेसरीज बनाई. और फिर हम उसको बाजार में सेल करने लगे, शॉप्स में, दो तीन शॉप्स हमने पकड़ ली और उसमें हम रेगुलर सेल करने लगे. दिल्ली हाट में मैं 2008 में पहली बार सिर्फ न्यूज़पेपर की क्विलिंग करके इयररिंग्स लेके बैठी थी एक टेबल पे. तो मेरे वहाँ पे बहुत अच्छा रिस्पॉन्स था, मेरा इतना अच्छा मोटिवेशन बना, तो मैंने वहाँ से फिर और अप करना शुरू किया. तो और लेडीज को जोड़ा, फिर धीरे धीरे, और इस तरह से हमारे पास बहुत सारी 30 लेडीज हो गई थी. बट लॉकडाउन में थोड़ी कम हो गई, पर हमने फिर क्वालिटी पे काम करा. अगर 6 लेडीज हैं तो हम क्वालिटी पे काम करते हैं. तो न्यूज़पेपर जो हमारे बैग हैं वो हमारे साल में 2 बार US जाते हैं. हमारे 4 कस्टमर हैं वहाँ पर जो हमसे रेगुलर लेते हैं. और जो हम ज्वेलरी बनाते हैं, ये कीचेन्स बनाते हैं, इसके अंदर हम पॉलीथीन भरते हैं और जो काट करके जो ओल्ड क्लॉथ होता है उसको भरते हैं इसके अंदर. और ये अपसाइकिल है. और हेयर एसेसरीज बनाते हैं जूड़ा स्टिक, और इसको हम दिल्ली हाट में और दस्तकार में. और हाँ, ये इला जी आपके जूड़े के लिए बहुत अच्छी लगेगा. सॉरी. और न्यूज़पेपर की क्वेलिंग देखिए, और हम बच्चों को भी सिखाते हैं, क्योंकि क्योंकि ये टॉपिक बच्चों के साथ भी कॉलेज में भी है, ये देखो ये वेस्ट क्लॉथ है, ये वेस्ट क्लॉथ है और इससे हम लोग ये सब ईयरिंग्स और बहुत सारी न्यू प्रोडक्ट्स बनाए अभी हमने लॉकडाउन में बैठ के बहुत सारे, और लेडीज इससे अपना घर चला रही हैं, 6 लेडीज यानी कि 6 परिवार चल रहे हैं, उनके साथ उनके बच्चे, और उन बच्चों को भी मैं आर्ट एंड क्राफ्ट की क्लासेस फ्री देती हूँ, बट जिस एनजीओ में मैं जाती हूँ ट्रेनिंग कर देने के लिए उनसे मैं चार्ज करती हूँ, क्योंकि हम लोगों को अपना सब सेंटर का सब अरेंजमेंट करना है, तो जो वेस्ट मटेरियल हमें मिलता है कई लोग तो हमें दिवाली में अपने घर से लाकर हमें सेंटर में दे देते हैं, क्योंकि उनके पास ट्रांसपोर्ट होता है, कई बार नहीं होता है तो हम आपस में कलेक्ट करके हम जाकर ले आते हैं, तो इस तरह से हम लोग अपसाइकिल करते हैं। अपसाइकिल में और देखो कीचेस, बुक मार्क और पेन में आजकल हमने सीड्स डालने शुरू करे हैं, तो उससे क्या होगा कि जो हम गेंदा के और उसके सीड्स डाल रहे हैं वो जहाँ पे यूज एंड थ्रू करके फेंका जाएगा तो वहाँ पर एक नई हरियाली आएगी और नए नए पौधे आएंगे, तो ये सब हम लोग अभी स्टार्ट किया है, कर दिया है हम लोगों ने नया नया, ये सब चीज ये क्लचर बनाते हैं हम, बहुत सारी चीजें बनाते हैं, और ये इसलिए आया कि वेस्ट जो है हमारा क्लॉथ वेस्ट होता है, इतना देखती हूँ मैं शॉप से इतना ढेर पड़ा होता है, तो उसको हम क्यों नहीं उसको और अप करके सुंदर सुंदर चीजें बनाएं, बस हमें सोचना पड़ेगा बहुत और कुछ आइडियाज लेने पड़ेंगे और कुछ ट्रेनिंग देनी पड़ेगी, तो इससे हम लोग आगे बढ़ सकते हैं और उससे भी कमाया जा सकता है, तो उससे भी हमारी 6 लेडीज कमा रही हैं, हमारा एनजीओ चल रहा है, एक छोटा सा ग्रुप है मेरा जान संदेश एनजीओ वो चल रहा है, तो बस ये सब काम कर रहे हैं और वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट के लिए और सेव द एनवायरमेंट के लिए काम कर रहे हैं, तो ये जो आज का डे है आज बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है मुझे आप लोगों के बीच में कि हम लोग सब मिलकर इतना सब कुछ सोच रहे हैं, और हम और लोगों को भी ट्रेन करेंगे, बच्चों को भी और ट्रेन करेंगे, क्योंकि वो चीजें ना बच्चों से और लोगों को सिखाने से एकदम थोड़ी धीरे धीरे चेंज आएगा, और बच्चा उसमें बहुत जरूरी है कि हम बच्चों को अगर सिखाते हैं तो वो बड़ा होकर जरूर रिसाइकल और अपसाइकिल के ऊपर काम करता है, ये एक छोटी सी सोच है जिससे हम लोग आगे बढ़े, और बस इस तरह से हम लोग काम कर रहे हैं, एम्पावरमेंट कर रहे हैं और आगे बढ़ते जा रहे हैं।
शांति जी कितने साल हो गए? कितने साल
मेरे को हो गए? मुझे 2000 से मैं कर रही हूँ, 2000
से
हाँ, और पर मेरे को मैं रेगुलर जो कर रही हूँ 2005 से रेगुलर कर रही हूँ, तब तक तो मैं स्ट्रगल करती रही, ढूंढती रही शॉप्स, ढूंढती रही, फिर उसके बाद मैंने घर से ही शुरुआत की, घर के अंदर में न्यूज़पेपर का बैग बनाती थी और पलंग के नीचे छुपा देती थी ये सोच के कि अभी शाम को जब बच्चे और हस्बैंड आएंगे कहेंगे पता नहीं क्या करती है ये, बट तो वो मेरा जाने लगा धीरे 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 ऑर्डर जाने लगा, तो जब एक बहुत बड़ा ऑर्डर आया और उससे मेरी ये सब एनजीओ का बहुत अच्छा टर्नओवर चल गया और हम लोग आगे बढ़े, तो इसी तरह से काम कर रहे हैं।
क्या बात है, 2005 से आप इतना अच्छा काम कर रही हैं, ऑलमोस्ट 16 साल हो गए हैं, कि शायद 16 साल पहले कई लोग जो हैं यहाँ पे या सुन रहे हैं या सुनेंगे शायद हमने कभी रिसाइकल अपसाइकल वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट सेग्रीगेशन इन सब चीजों के बारे में हमने शायद कभी सुना भी नहीं होगा, अखबार घर में आया अखबार को पढ़ा उसको उठा के फेंक दिया, ज्यादा से ज्यादा उसको रद्दी में बेच दिया, बट कभी ये नहीं सोचा कि रद्दी में बिकने के बाद उसका क्या होता है, और अगर हम इस चीज को सोचें जो पेपर बैग्स शांति जी बनाती हैं वो बैग्स इतने स्ट्रॉन्ग हैं कि उसमें पीला अपने प्लांट्स डाल के जो काफी भारी होते हैं वो डिलीवर होते हैं, तो इतनी उनमें स्ट्रेंथ होती है। ये जो पेन मैंने आप लोगों को दिखाया, ये जो पेन है ये शायद मैंने शांति जी से 2019 में खरीदे थे किसी एक इवेंट के लिए, तो जो पेन्स बचे वो मेरे पास हैं, पेपर के बने हुए हैं, आप इनसे लिखिए ये टूटते नहीं है, दे आर सो स्ट्रॉन्ग, एंड इन्होंने सिर्फ न्यूज़पेपर ही नहीं कलरफुल पेपर भी इस्तेमाल किए, तो अलग अलग रंग के हैं, सो एस्थेटिकली बहुत सुंदर हैं, लिखते बहुत बढ़िया हैं, और आपको भी एक फीलिंग आती है कि आप पर्यावरण के लिए इन्वायरमेंट के लिए कुछ कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट कर रहे हैं, और जो आई थिंक शांति जी आपने अभी आइडिया शेयर किया वो तो बहुत ही फैंटास्टिक है, पेन से लिखिए, पेन को मिट्टी में डाल दीजिए और वहां से पौधा उगाएगा, वंडरफुल, दैट इज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट संगीता वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट, अ क्लोज सर्किट, राइट, बहुत बहुत वेरी वेरी नाइस शांति जी. और आप जब ट्रेनिंग देती हैं, तो जब ये महिलाएं आती हैं आपके एनजीओ में इस चीज को सीखने के लिए, या जब बच्चे आते हैं, तो वो कितने क्या क्या सवाल पूछते हैं आपसे? क्या उन्हें लगता है कि अरे ये क्या हम कर रहे हैं, क्या अजूबा है ये?
हेलो हेलो.
हाँ जी, क्या आप मेरी आवाज सुन पा रही हैं?
वो बच्चे हम लोग जो बच्चों को ट्रेनिंग देते हैं एज के हिसाब से देते हैं, 3 to 5 एज के बच्चों के हिसाब से अलग. हेलो.
हाँ जी, हाँ जी, बोलिए.
हेलो
शांति जी, हम आपको सुन पा रहे हैं.
हेलो जी, नहीं सुन पा रही हूँ.
सुन पा रहे हैं हम आपको?
हेलो, नेटवर्क नहीं आ रहा शायद. आई नो, आपकी आवाज
आ रही है.
मेरी आवाज आ रही है?
आपकी आवाज आ रही है. अच्छी.
अच्छा, हम एज अकॉर्डिंग. ओके ओके, थैंक यू थैंक यू. एज अकॉर्डिंग हम लोग ज्वेलरी बनाना और ये पेपर की स्टेशनरी वगैरह ना सिखाते हैं बच्चों को अलग और लेडीज को अलग. 12 साल से ऊपर के बच्चों को हम लोग सुई धागा का काम सिखा सकते हैं और लेडीज को हम इजीली सिखा सकते हैं. उसमें कुछ करना नहीं है, बहुत आसान है. एक कच्चा करना होता है और एक हम कांच टांका जो हम बटन लगाते हैं, बस वो वाला टांका. हम दो टांके के ऊपर बहुत काम करते हैं जिसको कांथा कहते हैं, और उससे बहुत सुंदर सुंदर चीजें बनाते हैं. और छोटे बच्चों के साथ हम न्यूज़पेपर से फ्लावर्स बनाना, न्यूज़पेपर से कैरी बैग बनाना, पेन बनाना सिखाते हैं. और कुछ हैंगिंग है जो हम सिखाते हैं. या हमने स्कूल में श्री राम स्कूल में कराया, सरदार पटेल स्कूल में कराया है वर्कशॉप, और गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स में, प्राइवेट स्कूल्स में, सब में करा हुआ है हमने वर्कशॉप्स ये. और इसके लिए हम लोग चार्ज लेते हैं और आगे बच्चों को सिखाते हैं, और बच्चे सीख रहे हैं, आगे बढ़ रहे हैं. और हम राजस्थान में भी जाकर सिखा के आए टीचर्स वहाँ के महिला पंचायत को, तो वो लोग भी उससे अब आगे कमा रहे हैं. तो वो लोग कनेक्टेड है हम लोगों से, वो लोग कमा रहे हैं आगे. कह रहे दीदी मैडम हम इतना कमा रहे हैं उससे, न्यूज़पेपर कैरी बैग भी बना रहे हैं, ज्वेलरी भी बना रहे हैं, ये सब काम कर रहे हैं वो लोग.
वंडरफुल वंडरफुल, बहुत
अब आवाज में आ रही है. थैंक यू सो मच.
सो इमेजिन योर न्यूज़पेपर, योर क्लोथ एंड सो मेनी थिंग्स कैन बी रिसाइकल्ड, अपसाइकल्ड. I have grown seeing things being upcycled in my house. My mother has converted so many of her old saris, my late mom-in-law's old saris, into beautifully looking bed covers, any other linen material that you could have. I never saw a thing getting wasted in my house. Chahe wo ek choti si katran kyun na ho. So agar hum बचपन से ही बच्चों के अंदर उस चीज को इनग्रेन करें, तो शायद 20 साल बाद हमें वर्ल्ड एनवायरनमेंट डे के ऊपर ये सारी चीजें डिस्कस नहीं करनी पड़ेगी. एंड यू नो, कहीं ना कहीं वो फाइनेंशियल मेंटोर जो है वो कूद कूद के बाहर आ जाता है. सो इफ आई इवन कोरिलेट इट टू द डे टू डे लाइफ और इवन फ्रॉम अ मनी मैटर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, वन एज शांति सेड दैट upcycle it, it becomes a business opportunity, and there are about 6 to 7 families whose house is being run on this. The other thing is, if we teach our children to recycle and upcycle, they will understand the difference between the need, wants and desires. They will develop patience. They will understand the value of everything that they demand for. And in that whole process, you never know that you may actually create an entrepreneur at a young age. So one thing, which is protecting the environment, waste to wonder, can encompass every and any aspect of our life. Be it finance, be it HR management, be it being happy, to creating plans, to recycling, to teaching children. And the reason that I'm talking about these professions is because all of you present over here are representing those professions. We have Anita, who runs a play school, Monica, who's an HR expert, Sunita ji, who's a happiness coach, Vikas, who comes from a financial industry, myself also, Binu, Ila, Sangeeta, they all come from as it is protecting the environment.
an Aarti, a conscious person and a chartered accountant by profession, and so many more people. So isn't it actually a journey as beautiful as Ways to Wonder? And the wonder part is just one aspect that we understood from Shanti and from Sangeeta and Ila. But there are so much and more wonders that can be created. And I really have hope from each one of you here that if a 4.5-year-old child can keep thinking about recycling and upcycling anything and everything, that it has reached to a point that we have to tell her, ki beta, ye iska kuch nahi ho sakta hai, ye please bin mein jaane do. Then I'm sure we adults really need to think, ponder, so that we all can create wonders. There have been a lot of comments and questions. There was a question that Aarti had messaged on the chat box. Aarti, would you like to ask your question?
Sunita also has a question. First, I'll let Aarti ask. Yes.
Yeah. Firstly, I'd like to thank Ila, Sangeeta, and Shanti so much. It's been an amazing session. Thanks a ton. I actually do have a question for each one, but Ila, I'll ask you. Yes. You were mentioning, you know, the process of composting, which can be done at home. Yes. If you would just, tell a little more, like, what exactly it is that you do. Like, okay, so you segregate and put it all out. But I'm sure you have to add something to make it the organic fertilizer. So yeah. If you'll just tell a little bit, please.
There are two or three ways to go about it, Aarti. Okay.
Okay.
One is making liquid fertilizers.
Okay.
So you just soak the vegetable peels in water for minimum of 24 hours or a maximum of 72 hours. I'll need to excuse myself. The door has opened and the traffic noise is coming inside. Just a minute.
Sure.
Sorry. Yeah. So yeah. The first is liquid fertilizer. So you just have to soak the peels. It could be onion peel fertilizer, banana peel fertilizer, vegetable peel fertilizer, whatever it is. You soak it in water for 24 hours or 36 hours, depending upon you. And then you strain that water, dilute it further with the amount, and then you spray it on your leaves, on the plants. And you can also add it to the soil. That is the simplest that one can do. Okay.
Okay.
Second would be keep collecting those vegetable and fruit peels in a bin as Ekta does. And I also do it. So I have kept a small bucket, a covered bucket in the corner near the sink. So whatever peels get collected, that they are collected, they are dumped there. Okay. Again, either you add, top it with lots of water, or you can take a bin, usme ek layer aapne vegetable peels ka, fruit peels ka lagaya, uske upar aapne soil dal diya thoda sa jaggery dal dijiye, fermentation ki process ko decompose karne ke liye jaldi ho jata hai, aise karte karte layering karte jaiye, dabate jaiye, aur aapko 2-3 mahine ke andar badhiya compost mil jayegi. Process lamba hai, lekin it is going, the quality of that compost is unmatched. Aapko market se sirf kachra hi milta hai, jisko aap sachi maayne mein kachra bolte ho. And you can one-on-one, aap mere se koi bhi contact kar sakte ho. I can actually guide you. And similarly, this is the way I make compost at home. And one more thing that skipped my mind while I was talking is the menace that aajkal hum jitna bhi Amazon or Flipkart se order karte ho, cardboard boxes mein aata hai saman. उन बॉक्सेस को भी तो सब डस्टबिन में डालते हैं।
यस।
उसको भी आप काट करके पानी में भिगो के कंपोस्टिंग के काम में ले सकते हो। People who have got gardens at home, especially summers हैं, अगर आप उन कार्डबोर्ड के टुकड़ों को भिगो करके और सॉइल के ऊपर डाल दोगे, बिछा दोगे, जहां पे भी पेड़ पौधा लगा है वहां पे टॉप सॉइल के ऊपर बिछा दोगे, तो वहां पर नमी बनी रहेगी, water retention rahega, and you will not need to water your plants more frequently.
Okay.
Similarly, jo bhi leaves waste ho rahi hai garden ke andar, wo mulching ke liye, there's a process called mulching. Like, we can have a separate session some other time.
Yeah.
because we have time constraints. So there are many, many and more things that can be done with kitchen waste and house waste. टिश्यू रोल, टिश्यू पेपर, किचन टिश्यू यूज किया हमने डस्टबिन में डाला, उसको भी आप कंपोस्टिंग में डाल दीजिए.
ओके.
बहुत सारी चीजों से हमारे पास जैसे छोटी क्रीम की डिब्बी आई है उसकी जो पैकेजिंग है उसके अंदर सीड्स उगा दीजिए, जब उसमें से कुछ उग जाएगा तो उसको एज इट इज पॉट में डाल दीजिए, वो पेपर से बना है पैकेजिंग, वो डिकम्पोज हो जाएगा एंड यू गेट अ न्यू प्लांट. सो देर आर मेनी मेनी थिंग्स दैट वी कैन डू एट पर्सनल लेवल.
थैंक यू. May I ask Sangeeta also a question?
Yeah, go ahead, Aarti.
Yeah. Hi, Sangeeta. You know, I am part of a fairly large complex. All probably educated or doing well. But believe me, I don't feel very proud when I say that most of us are not doing anything like even close to what you mentioned. So where would you say we start off, you know, even if it's one or two, there are enough interested people, but nobody has gotten together to make an effort. So what would you suggest since you have already done this?
Oh, yes. See, that's exactly the point of my presentation was that how do you implement it? So like I said, if you make a core team of passionate people, you know, and go into this the science of waste management, which is really not rocket science, it's just basic. We need to tell people to segregate. So how shall we do that? So we do draw up a plan together. Are you going to make posters? Or are you going to create some creative? Are you going to, you can put it in WhatsApp groups. Now there are, you know, communication is so easy. Even when we started back in 2002, all these things were not there. So we're just making, you know, posters, getting it printed, putting it here, there, putting it with the newspaper so that everybody gets it. And then saying that, no, you have to do this. We will give you this much time. Get into the rigor. After which, you know, if after it becomes a rule in the society, then if you are not going to do it, your kachra will not be picked up. So that is the last thing. So you don't want to antagonize people. So, you know, do it in a very gentle, soft way, saying that this is you're doing it for the good of the earth. And, you know, see, the problem is good of the earth, it becomes very lofty for some people. That is the biggest problem, you know. So that is why in my presentation I gave all this thing about this story about Ghazipur and the all that, because see, there are lives being impacted by what you are doing. So that is something we all need to discuss and say that let us do it. And you know, probably we will get publicity. You know, everybody likes publicity these days. You know, some of carrot has to be dangled, you know, but that's a way of going. So like I said, a core team has to be formed. You debate it, you know, chalk out a plan. This is how we're going to do it, you know, and then execution, you know, basically that's how it can be done.
So if we need any knowledge or guidance, can I get back to you on this?
Absolutely.
One?
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right. Thank you.
Sunita has a question.
Yeah, sorry.
Thank you, Ila and Ekta for arranging such a beautiful meeting. Thank you, Sangeeta and Shanti ji. I have a question for Shanti ji. Shanti ji, मेरी खुद की एक NGO है जहाँ पर बहुत सी लड़कियाँ आती हैं training के लिए. तो मैं चाहूंगी जो आप जो वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट सिखाती हैं तो उसकी ट्रेनिंग अपने इंस्टीट्यूट में करवाने के लिए, तो आप करवा सकती हैं ना?
जी बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, आप बुलाइए हमें प्लीज, हम जरूर
तो जैसे ही लॉकडाउन ओपन अप होता है और कंडीशंस फेवरेबल होती हैं, आई विल बी इन टच विद यू. तो आप
हम तो चाहेंगे कि और लोग सीखें और बच्चे भी सीखें, सब सीखें.
Exactly, मैं आपका पॉइंट समझ गई थी, तो मुझे यही था कि थोड़ी कंडीशंस फेवरेबल हो जाएं क्योंकि इंस्टीट्यूट भी खुल जाए जरा हमारा. हमने भी क्लोज कर रखा है जी, तो मैं आपसे डायरेक्ट कांटेक्ट में रहूंगी और फिर हम इस पर वर्कआउट कर सकते हैं.
जी जरूर
सुपर. सो लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, वेस्ट टू वंडर पार्ट 1, दिस वाज Very soon we will come with Waste to Wonder Part 2. Stay tuned for the details. And thank you so much for being here with us. And I hope we are able to make a little bit of a difference towards protecting the environment, to ourselves. And if any one of you implements any of these suggestions, ideas, inputs that were shared by Ila, Sangeeta, and Shanti ji, we would love to hear from you as to what you did and what was the feeling that you experienced and how many more did you influence. As they say, the proof of the pudding is eating it. So if we have to eat it, we have to appreciate it. And if we appreciate it, you need to let us know that you did something. So with this, thank you so much for being here with us. And soon we will be back with the details of Ways to Wonder Part 2. Thank you, Sangeeta, Shanti, and Ila for an amazing session.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Great session. Great session.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Take care and stay safe.
Take care. Take care, all. Take care. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.